So I decided to open the video with a rap, hoping that that, like a rope and a lasso, would then grab your focus and have you wanting to stay, bro, cause I'm back to explain the idea of remixing a flow that I had. What's up, y'all? It's Sage. So today I want to share with you guys a little idea that I came up with recently that I'm going to refer to as flow remixing. Now first, just to make sure that we're all starting off on the same page, whenever I use the word flow, what I'm referring to is the way in which a rapper chooses to translate what they want to say into rhymes, and then also how they choose to structure those rhymes on the beat. Let's take a look at a little example real quick just to help illustrate what exactly I mean by that. This first line will end with bat. This second line will end with cat. This third line will end with bat. And this fourth line will end with cat. So that was kind of a really bare bones example of what I would consider to be essentially the most basic flow possible. Because it, for instance, used one-syllable rhymes, an average of one time per line, and the cadence or the rhythm of speech being used was essentially as simplistic as possible, right? Da 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 da. So, keeping those same three metrics in mind, now compare that with this. Listening track with me as I exist to rap. This like that is another sentence to pack up with some fat rhymes until it is in fact just as fancy as a frickin' aristocrat. So that was another sort of really bare bones example of a flow, but this time of a bit more complex flow, because using the same metrics as before, it had three syllable rhymes being used an average of twice per line, and the cadence or the rhythm of speech being used was just a bit more interesting and fit the beat a bit better, right? So those were two really simple examples of kind of the opposite ends of the flow spectrum of how you can put rhymes onto a beat, right? Now, obviously, there is a lot more to the technical side of MCing than just flow. There's also content, which is what the artist is saying, and there's vocal delivery, which is how the artist uses their voice to physically perform the lyrics. And of course, all three of these categories break down even further. But for today, we're only going to focus on the first two, content and flow. Because the idea that I mentioned earlier was to take another artist's existing lyrics, which were originally written with a more straightforward flow, and see if I could keep the content of what they're saying exactly the same, but take the rhyme structures that they used and rearrange and augment them a little bit to create a new version of the song, a remixed version, that says all the same things, but says them using a flow that is a bit more complex, a bit more interesting. Hence the term flow remixing. So, now that we've gotten all the definitional context out of the way, I'd like to show you a couple examples of what this actually sounds like in action. So, first, here is the original version of the first four bars of Drake's song, Over.
It's over, but it's far from over.
Bottles on me, long as someone drink it. Never drop the ball, the f*** are y'all thinking? Making sure the young money ship is never sinking. About to set it off in this beat, Jada Pinkett. And my flow remix of it.
It's over, but it's far from over.
Models around me, as long as someone drink it. Never dropping the ball like a moss when I'm going off on a beat, bro. What are y'all thinking? I'm making freaking certain that the young money ship that our crew sail ain't sinking. The haters are thinking it, but the making believe makers, we are finna set it off in it like Jada Pinkett. So looking at the original versus my flow remix, obviously I had to change out a couple words for words that were different but mean the same thing, and then I also had to add in a couple phrases, but the point being that while I significantly rearranged the structure of the flow, I was able to keep the vast majority of the original lyrics intact. Now, before I show you guys the second example, there are just two disclaimers I want to cover real quick before people start getting mad at me in the comments. First, this is in no way meant to disrespect Drake or any of the other artists in this video at all. I have a tremendous amount of respect for Drake. I think that he's a very talented artist. I think that the flow that he used on this particular song is a great example of the sort of laid-back signature flow that he tends to use, and I think that it fit this song really well. The whole point of me doing this is, again, not to crap on Drake. It's just because I, as a rapper, tend to personally prefer hearing more complex flows, and I thought that it'd be kind of fun, kind of interesting to see if I'd be able to do this. Second, I'm very well aware that not everyone is going to be the same as me in that regard, in that not everyone is going to prefer more complex flows over, for example, more laid-back flows. Like, for instance, I'm very well aware that there are going to be plenty of people who would prefer Drake's version of that over mine. I completely understand that. I'm not in any way trying to insinuate that my version of that is somehow inherently better than his. Okay, so now that we've gotten that crap out of the way,
Here is the original version of the first four bars of Quavo's verse on Post Malone's song Congratulations.
I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I got a situation. Never all been Ben Franklin's. Big rings, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in the trap, though. Pot so big, call it Super Bowl.
And here is my best attempt at keeping the lyrical content as similar as possible while augmenting the rhyme structures in order to create a more interesting flow.
I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But hot dang, even in a situation, it's all gravy. And nobody no old money, it's all lately. And y'all may be wondering where I've been, frankly. Keeping it 100 like always. See the big rings of champagne and pot crazier than the Super Bowl. My life is a ball game, yeah.
So now in this example, I kind of had to rearrange the original lyrics more than I had in the previous example. The first line was pretty much the same, but I had to move the Ben Franklin reference from the second line to the third line. I had to move the big ring champagne, life like a ball game references to the fourth line. And then I added in the keeping it 100 wordplay with the Ben Franklin thing in the third line. But the point being that between the original and the flow remix, I was able to keep, again, the vast majority of the original ideas and also a lot of the original phrasing intact in remixing the flow, even if I had to take a little bit more liberty in rearranging the order of the ideas. And for the third and final example, here's the original version of the first four bars of designer song, Panda.
I got broads in Atlanta, twisting dopamine in the Phantom, credit cards in the scammers, hitting off licks in the banner, black X6 Phantom, white X6 look like a panda, going out like a Montana, 100 killers, 100 hammers.
And the flow remix.
Man, I got broads in Atlanta, twisting dope, lean in a fan of credit cards and a scammers, hitting off licks in a banner, black X6 Phantom, and a white X6 looks like a panda, going out like a Montana, against 100 killers, 100 hammers, black X6 Phantom.
So if there's like a spectrum of how well I'm able to preserve the original lyrics, and the Drake example was kind of in the middle, and the Quavo example was more on the liberal end of the spectrum, this example was kind of on the opposite end of that spectrum, because I don't know if you noticed or not, but lyrically speaking, I actually didn't change anything this time. All I did was add two words. Everything else is exactly the same. So this would probably actually be the most pure example of a flow remix because the content was virtually unchanged. Literally all that I changed was the way that I pronounced the rhymes on the beat. So yeah, I think that all pretty much encapsulates the idea of flow remixing. I hope that you guys found this to be entertaining or interesting to some extent. If I'm going to be completely honest, as I'm filming this, I don't really have any idea if anyone else will find this idea to be even remotely as interesting as I do, but hoping and assuming that you do, assuming that you're still watching at this point, if you might be interested in hearing me do the same process to an entire song, then you're in luck, because that is exactly what I've done. I've flow remixed an entire song, recorded it, and edited it, and I'll be uploading it sometime within the next week. So if that's something that you'd be interested in hearing, then make sure you hit the subscribe button and or stick around to check that out and see what that sounds like. Just one final thought that I wanted to end the video with, and that is that I feel like whenever somebody makes a video like this, usually there are gonna be some people who watch it and feel like they wanna try it themselves. And for anybody watching who may be in that boat, I just wanted to make it very clear that if I might make the process that I've been referring to this whole time look simple, it's actually anything but. It's actually very complicated, and the only reason that I might be able to make it look easy is just because I've been doing it for so long, right? It's the same way that like an open heart surgeon might make doing open heart surgery look simple, when in reality it's actually very complicated, and the only reason that it's easy for him is because he's been doing it for so long, right? So bottom line, I would recommend that you just don't even bother trying, because there really isn't any point. The only reason that I did this is because I've been writing rhymes for so long and I thought that it'd be kind of a fun idea to try. But if for whatever reason you still feel compelled to try it, just don't feel bad if it turns out to be a lot more difficult than you had anticipated, because it is actually really complicated. That's all. So yeah, I think that's pretty much everything. Thank you again to everybody so much for watching. Hope you guys found it interesting. If you enjoyed the video, please feel free to leave a like, subscribe, share the video, all those other things that YouTubers always beg you to do. And hope you guys have a fantastic day. Thanks. Bye. Where are you going? Where are you going? Huh? You got better places to be? You little jerk.
I have been known to make an a-hole run. I'm the KO pectator of the rap game, though. Come for them lame old punks that'll stay reigning the same old chunk. I'm going up making John Snow on them because they know nothing about. coming up out from the underground and seeing nothing but shadows of rappers thinking now. Then maybe you punks will taunt me, but film me, and how did you clowns end up hogging the spotlight? You're grounded.